our sanctuary. Nature is my inspiration for what I do and who I am. Our sanctuary, in my eyes, is what we're surrounded by, so our nature. So the majority of these pieces are literally just created with the natural shades of New Zealand sand. They don't have any dye in it, no paint. So I literally paint with adhesive and paint brushes and apply each shade layer by layer, line by line, let it dry, do the next shade, and then they're all overspread with a clear coat or resin to protect them forever. So they obviously don't fade either because it's a natural product. For the real dark, colorful things like the green, I use crushed glass just to get a little bit more color into it. The red is also just a natural sand, and the real pale green is actually dug up 300 meters underground. So I've got a lot of people contacting me now, bringing me sand from wherever they're going and traveling. So I actually got my collection is a wider range in New Zealand now. I've got over 60 different shades of sand, not just from New Zealand, also from overseas. And where was I? So yes, and so the blue as well, obviously, is crushed glass. Unless somebody can tell me where I can find blue sand, I'd be really appreciative about that. Once the borders open again, I know where to go. I think there's a Rainbow Mountain in China somewhere, so I might have to do a little trip, a business trip. Yes, so the main subject of my work is nature, but I also do a lot of commission work, so portraits of people, animals. I've also done tractors, planes, you name it. People have different interests, so yeah. I welcome you all. Have a look around, have a little feel if you've got any questions of how I do what.
Well, can we just talk a little bit about how you actually make them? So you'll start with, say, the circular work, and then will you cover it with a gesso or a white paint, or what's underneath the sand? What's the first layer you would put on?
Okay, so yeah, if I start on a normal board, yes, I put a primer underneath, a white primer, and then just go from here. And then I just paint, literally, I usually start with the eyes because that's what has to be correct. Mm. So when I do portraits of people, I draw down the eyes, but it's not like painting, I can't draw down everything because as soon as I put the sand down, you can't see what's underneath.
So if you were doing a painting with acrylic or something, you'd be actually be rocking in the whole figure first, but you're not. You actually have to start with the detail and build detail out from detail.
Yeah, and you can also, I'd say, if you do acrylic, you can do the background first, then draw down what you want to paint. What I can't do that.
No.
I have to literally, it's almost like painting by numbers, but you got to know where to put the numbers. And I can't go lighter again either, so. Some of the canvases, like this has only real light, doesn't actually get any sand on it. So it's
the light tends to let the white come through. So it's a little bit like watercolour in the sense that the white is the background.
Yeah. Because I can't, like I said before, if I painted everything black and then started putting the white on, it would never be white. It would never be crisp again.
So you really have to think about those layers, and it's quite a difficult way of thinking.
Do you use different size brushes? Like, how do you get the sand onto the frame?
Definitely. So each line of the wood carver is done with a tiny, teeny little fine paintbrush. And I just do line by line. Obviously do bit by bit as well, because otherwise by the time you paint it on them.
But do you just dip the brush into sand and then put it on there, or do you drop it down, or?
Yeah, so I just do, say, for instance, like five lines, sprinkle sand on, whatever doesn't stick comes off again, goes back into the container. So I'm very resourceful, very save everything.
Quite methodical, you have to be,
wouldn't
you?
Yeah, I'm definitely not wasteful. so I have different paintbrushes.
It's painstaking.
Can be.
It's almost like a tapestry. You know, it's got that sort of slow time aspect to it.
Yeah.
I'm interested in the brushes. So when you're using the adhesive, what does that wash out with? The longevity of your brushes? for instance. How do you clean them?
It's just a water-based
adhesive. Oh, water-based,
yeah.
Okay.
Oh, so
right.
That's pretty easy.
Yeah, okay, that does make it easier.
And I have been looking into actual natural adhesive as well, because I do, for me, it's all about the sustainability. It's all about bringing people back in connection with nature, because I think we focus too much on everything else we're producing. Like, if you feel sick, you feel overwhelmed, what do? You take medication rather than actually going outside and using and enjoying what is given to us by our beautiful planet. That's what it's all about. Getting goosebumps. Yeah, so yeah, I love it.
Well, it's nice to have, you know, have that background, that kind of holistic approach and sustainability being key to you,
yeah,
to your worldview.
And yeah, and I really enjoy the sparkle. And what I notice as well is, like, at night time, it comes out even more. I used to tell people, like, if you got a really nice sunny spot in your house, like, you should hang it there. But I also noticed, and I think it's because the light only comes from one angle. So, like, as you can see right now, like, this is so glittery, you know, and I just love that.
Well, we changed the lighting slightly the other day to bring it into life a little bit.
Yeah. And then some works have a little bit of gold leaf in it, also to enhance certain details.
So would that be that circular work there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did
and
you,
also these little tins.
Did you go somewhere to be taught to do this, or did you teach yourself by trial and error?
I'm still learning every day. So I'm from Germany originally. And I've always been into art. My granddad was an artist and my uncle also was an artist. So the creativity is already within me. I wanted to become a wood carver, but that never, I don't know, my parents didn't take me seriously, I don't think. And I probably didn't take myself seriously in that matter either. And when I came to New Zealand, I saw black sand for the first time. So I was like, oh, what an interesting contrast and texture on my normal acrylic paintings. Then I got white sand and I did. So I started in 2003 and I did black and white, semi-deco art style paintings, and it just evolved from there.
Did you just taught yourself
how
to do? Well done.
Yeah, and now I've got over 60 different shades of sand, so if I'm moving again, I need a digger. No, I actually don't need much. Like, you wouldn't believe how long the sand lasts, because it's... Most of these paintings are all—it's just one shade of sand, so it could sometimes just be a handful that gets you quite calm.
Very beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you, Nancy. It'd be quite interesting if you could do a workshop at some stage. I'm just thinking, teaching that technique to school children could be quite a good idea. Oh, you do.
Yeah. I also just started doing sand and zip nights. So once a month we meet at the lookout in Puke, lookout kitchen. So it's like a really nice restaurant, and I can take up to 25 people, and you come along and you socialize with your friends or partner, and I teach you a little bit about how to do sand painting. Obviously never enough time, so we do the majority of, so how I started, acrylic paint in the background, and then you do tiny details in sand.
Yes.
Just do
yeah,
like,
so you adapted it for that time frame.
I've done school courses, I guess. So I did like a whole stint of 4 weeks, and every Friday I went into the school. So we did it from designing your piece to drawing it down and then finishing it over the 4 weeks. And I also done these sort of courses in my own studio. So in school holidays, I invite people or kids along, and it only take up to 12.
12's enough.
Yeah. And I also done it in retirement villages, because I know people just love using their hands.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
And it's very therapeutic, so.
Oh, thanks, Nancy.
Unbelievable.
Are there any other questions for Nancy before we.
Do you draw it first, or do you just grow it?
Just sometimes. It depends what I'm drawing. Like I said, like, mainly the eyes and the nose with the birds. It really just depends what it is.
So how long does it take for you, for example, the tool, you know, detail?
I would say around that one is really detailed.
Yeah, that's what I saw.
So even like considering that, it wouldn't have taken me as long as that one because I literally sit down and try and do all the lines on top of the green and then.
Yeah. And all of this would have been quite tricky because the white is the first layer. Is it?
This one I did the opposite way because I was like, I'm making it really hard for myself. So I started putting it down and actually using a toothpick to go back and scrape it out. But this one I actually painted on top with white.
Otherwise,
you don't have to be that strict with yourself. So I reckon about 30 to 40 hours for the toy. And I obviously don't ever work on just one piece, otherwise I'll just be sitting there waiting, twiddling my thumbs up with one shade dry.
Dry time.
So I usually have a lot of pieces on the go.
Well, congratulations on your show. It's absolutely beautiful, and we've had so much interest. There's been a lot of interest in that eye, the bird on the left up there, people come in and really drawn to that place. So thank you very much, Nancy.